Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's talk about using the proper names for Apple products. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So anybody in tech support or that answers questions about Apple products like I do knows that a lot of people don't use the proper names when referring to Apple products. This can make it difficult sometimes to convey the issue that you're having or the problem you want to solve. Sometimes people are using older names for Apple products or using the name of an older product that's since been replaced. And other times people are just using slang instead of the proper product name. But using the right product name can really help when you're trying to communicate. Here's my first example. Sometimes people may say they have an Air or a Mac Air or even an Apple Air. But Air is a term used by Apple for several different products. So it helps to clearly state that you're using, say, a MacBook Air or an iPad Air. There is no product simply called the Mac Air. Another example is somebody may say they have a MacBook. And Apple actually did produce a MacBook just called a MacBook for a few years. Chances are that if you don't have an actual MacBook, you have a MacBook Pro or a MacBook Air. Now I may use the term MacBook, but when I do it, I'm referring to something about a MacBook, MacBook Pro, or MacBook Air, something that could apply to all three. Like for instance saying that when you close the lid on a MacBook, it goes to sleep. In that case, it doesn't matter which MacBook you have. But if you're asking for help for something, it's very useful to state that you have a MacBook Pro or MacBook Air rather than just saying MacBook. I've also seen some people just say that they've got a Pro when asked what type of Mac they have. And Apple uses the term Pro through a lot of different product lines. So it's helpful to really define what you have. Chances are you're probably talking about a MacBook Pro, but you may also have a Mac Pro, which is an expensive tower that Apple sells. Also, for a number of years, Apple produced an iMac Pro. And Apple also uses this term in other lines. For instance, you could have an iPad Pro or even an iPhone 12 Pro. Less frequently, I hear people talking about having an iPod now. Now, Apple hasn't produced an actual iPod in many years. Chances are if you say you have an iPod now, you're actually talking about an iPod Touch. But it definitely helps to be clear because an iPod Touch is an iOS device similar to an iPhone, whereas an iPod is a much older device with a very limited operating system. It basically just stores and plays back music. Now, if you say you have an iPad, you may actually have an iPad. Apple does, of course, produce a model called just the iPad. But you may also have an iPad Pro, iPad Air, or iPad Mini. It helps to really talk about which one that you've got, especially now where iPad Pros have a very different processor and capabilities from the standard iPad and iPad Mini. Another one I hear often is somebody saying they have an iPhone SE. Now, the SE is the lower end iPhone model. So if you say you have an iPhone SE, it's very possible that you're referring to the original iPhone SE, which is many years old now, and it's very limited in what it can do compared to current iPhones. However, there is an iPhone SE 2. It's not called that. Apple actually contributes to this because they call both of them just the iPhone SE. But the original iPhone SE from several years ago and the iPhone SE that you could buy today are very different in terms of their capabilities. In general, when referring to iPhone or iPad models, it's important to state the exact model name, or if the model name doesn't have any specifics like the iPhone SE, talk about the year that it came out. Now here's one that's completely wrong. There is no product called the iWatch. Apple's never produced an iWatch. However, that was a rumored name for the Apple Watch from a long time ago, and of course there's the iPhone, so it makes sense to call it the iWatch. But Apple actually doesn't make an iWatch. It's called the Apple Watch. Another one I see is often people just say HomePod, but there are actually two different HomePods. There's the HomePod and HomePod Mini. Now, Apple originally produced the HomePod, which is larger than the Mini, and they've since discontinued it. Now, if you buy a HomePod, it's actually the HomePod Mini. But when referring to them, it's important to use the right name because they have different capabilities. Now, this is very much misused in the press, especially because it's often mentioned that the HomePod has been discontinued. Of course, if people want to get a HomePod, they can get a HomePod Mini. It's a fairly new product and very much supported by Apple. So when you see a headline that says the HomePod's been discontinued or it's impossible to get a HomePod now, keep in mind the HomePod is the original product. The HomePod Mini is the one that you could easily get now from Apple's site. I often hear people misusing the name of Apple's earphones. Now, the original earphones, the ones that had an audio jack, people refer to them as simply earbuds. And earbuds is actually a generic name for earphones that fit into your ears and are wired and you connect them to a device. Apple then went to EarPods, and EarPods have a lightning connector on the end of them and they're a little more advanced than the old earbuds. AirPods, of course, are the wireless devices that are really popular now from Apple. Here's a big one. People will still use the term OS X or OS X sometimes. And Apple actually hasn't produced OS X in a while. They changed the name to macOS. If you've got an older version of macOS, it may have originally been referred to as OS X. And in that case, it's technically fine to refer to it. You can say OS X Sierra, for instance, and that is fine. That's correct. But if you say macOS Sierra, that's correct too, and it's a little clearer. Now, iPhoto is the app that came with Macs for a long time that helped you manage your photos. And the name actually really stuck with people, and people still use it. However, for years now, the name of the app that comes on your Mac is called Photos. iPhoto and Photos are different apps. Photos was created from the ground up. It wasn't simply a new version of iPhoto. A major difference, for instance, is that iPhoto had no iCloud capability, so you couldn't store your photos in the cloud, one of the best features of the Photos app. I still see people referring to Photos as iPhoto, and it's very confusing when you're trying to give somebody help, because when I see somebody say iPhoto, I immediately think they're using a much older version of macOS or they're still sticking with the old iPhoto app. And when trying to provide help and instructions, you really want to know which one it is people are using. Other examples of this are iCal and iBooks. These are previous names for apps that Apple has since replaced. They're now simply called Calendar or Books. Books is a little confusing because Apple often refers to the Books app as Apple Books. Sometimes Apple refers to the store inside of the Books app as the Apple Books Store or just the bookstore. So it's a little confusing there, but it's definitely not called iBooks. This is getting rarer, but sometimes you'll see people refer to iWork. iWork was a marketing term that referred to Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. They originally were sold on optical media as a single piece of software. You installed it and you got these three apps. But when Apple moved these to the App Store, they became individual apps and they're simply referred to as Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. To confuse things further, Apple still kept referring to them for a while as iWork or iWork apps, sometimes on their website or in support forums and things like that. But I find it's much better just to forget about the iWork name completely and talk about Pages, Numbers, or Keynote specifically. Another one here is people will refer to Final Cut as Final Cut 10 or Final Cut X or Final Cut Pro X, but the actual name of the app is simply Final Cut Pro. iTunes is a big one, and it's made more confusing by the fact that Apple used the word iTunes for a lot of different things. For instance, there was an app on the Mac called iTunes, but there was also the iTunes Store. Today, iTunes is still technically a term. Inside of the music app, for instance, you can purchase music in the iTunes Store. But on the Mac, the apps are called simply Music, TV, Podcasts, and Books. These are the apps that have taken over all the different functions of the old iTunes app. So when talking about one of these, be sure to refer to it by name, like Music. If you say iTunes, then immediately someone like me would think that you're using a much older version of macOS that still has the iTunes app. Related to that is the term Apple Music. Now this one is particularly confusing because people use Apple Music to refer to the app on their Mac, which is just called Music, not Apple Music, and also the service, the streaming service that's kind of like Spotify where you can pay a subscription fee and stream any music that you want. So technically the app is just called Music and the streaming music service is called Apple Music. This term can lead to a lot of confusion as I've had a lot of back and forth with somebody asking about Apple Music. And I think they're talking about the streaming service and they're just talking about the app on their Mac and they're not using Apple Music at all. Apple News is another one. This is a little clearer, but remember that the app on your Mac is actually just called News. Apple News doesn't really apply to anything, but note that Apple News Plus is the subscription service for $5 a month where you can get all sorts of magazines in the News app for that one monthly fee. Apple TV is another one. Apple TV actually refers to the physical device, the one that you buy and hook up to a television. The app on your Mac is just called TV. So don't refer to that as Apple TV, else people will think you're talking about the actual device you connect to a television. Apple TV Plus is the service that you get for $5 a month that includes shows like Mythic Quest and Ted Lasso. iCloud is another term that's misused. iCloud refers to the entire service, which includes things like syncing up your contacts and calendars, using space for backups, tons of different things. But a lot of times people are talking about specifically iCloud Drive, which is the part of iCloud that lets you store files. So say if you have your documents and desktop folder in iCloud, you're actually saying they're in iCloud Drive, which is part of iCloud. In addition, this is going to get more confusing because Apple is adding the term iCloud Plus. Basically, iCloud is just going to be this generic term for the whole service. If you actually pay for extra storage, you have what's called iCloud Plus. This term is going to come into use with the new operating systems in the fall. So those are the most common misuses of Apple product names that I see from day to day, either in questions I get or on forums online. It may seem trivial to talk about the differences between terms like MacBook and MacBook Pro or iCal and Calendar, but if you're searching for information or trying to get help, being clear about these terms can really help you get the information that you want. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.